knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Moving along with our analysis of Arthropoda, we reach subphylum Myriapoda. The name Myriapoda comes from the ancient Greek murios, meaning 10,000, and pous, meaning foot. However, only a few orders of millipedes actually have that many legs, while most have far less than 100. In order to better study them, we will go over their general characteristics, body systems, reproduction and development, ecology, and classification. Myriapods are bilaterally symmetrical arthropods protected by a chitinous exoskeleton. They are characterized by their elongated bodies composed of numerous segments. Their primary body regions are the head, or acron, which is protected in many species by a column, followed by the multi-segmented trunk. This may contain less than 20 segments, like in some pill millipedes that closely resemble pill bugs, or hundreds, like in eumillipedes, which has more than 600. Many, except for the house centipedes, lack compound eyes, and most have a single pair of antennae. Their mouthparts are on the ventral end of the head, which are modified in predatory species like centipedes to include a venomous maxilliped, which is absent in the herbivorous species such as millipedes. Myriapods have a complete digestive system, which is long and tubular and runs most of the length of the body. Food that passes through the mouth enters the esophagus, which may represent the majority of the length of the digestive system in centipedes, followed by the foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Undigested food passes out the terminal anus. Their excretory system is primarily comprised of paired Malpighian tubules that discharge nitrogenous waste filtered from the hemolymph directly into the gut at a junction in the mid and hindgut. Nitrogenous waste then passes out the anus along with any undigested food. Myriapods, like all arthropods, have an open circulatory system maintained by a dorsal tubular heart that runs along the length of the trunk. Hemolymph is moved into and out of the heart by ostia. Their respiratory system allows gas exchange through tubular trachea that deliver oxygen directly to the tissues without the need of blood. The trachea open into the environment through a series of spiracles located on each body segment. Like all arthropods, myriapods do not breathe through their mouths. Instead, their spiracles and tracheal system transport oxygen directly to cells and release carbon dioxide. The spiracles are located ventrally in millipedes and laterally in centipedes. The myriapod nervous system is comprised of a circumesophageal brain, meaning it is arranged around the esophagus, and a double ventral nerve cord with ganglia at each segment. Many species have highly sensitive antennae capable of perceiving touch and chemical components, along with simple or compound eyes in some species, and sensory hairs, or setae. Myriapods are dioecious, meaning they are either male or female, and sexual reproduction is internal, but varies widely by class and order. In many species, like the centipedes, symphylins, and some millipedes, males and females never actually meet. There is no internal copulation. Males simply leave packets of sperm, known as spermatophores, for females to find. Males ejaculate using a penis located at their terminal segment and manipulated into a spermatophore using their gonopods. Some species leave their eggs in small webs they excrete from their spinnerets. In other species, like many millipedes, reproduction is carried out through direct copulation where the males use their gonopods to transfer packets of sperm to the female. Unlike the centipedes, most millipede gonopods are located closer to the head, and reproduction generally occurs face-to-face and may involve intricate behaviors on the male's part, such as tapping, offering edible glandular secretions, or even chirping in some species of giant pill millipedes. Regardless, after the female has received the sperm and finds a suitable area, she lays her eggs and fertilizes them with the spermatophore as she does so. Often, she finds or digs a suitable area to lay her eggs and leaves them. But in some species, like many centipedes, the female stays with the eggs and cleans and cares for them until they hatch. Other species may construct nests and guard their young, and in still other species, the male stays with the female until she lays the eggs and then guards them until they hatch. Often, the young hatch after just a few weeks and are born with just a few pairs of legs, with additional legs being added with each molt. This is known as euanamorphosis. In other species, the young are born looking like miniature versions of their parents and do not add additional legs with each molt. The amount of time from juvenile to adult varies widely. Some may become adults in just a few months, while others may take up to 3 years to sexually mature. As such, lifespans vary by species from under 1 year for some of the smallest species in temperate areas to over 10 years in some tropical species. Ecologically, myriapods are most abundant in temperate and tropical forests, where some species, like the millipedes and pauropods, are important detritivores, helping to break down decaying plant material. They are especially important in forests where earthworm populations may be low. Some species, like some Subphylums, are common and persistent soil crop pests. These may be especially common and difficult to eradicate in greenhouses. Others, like the centipedes, are generalist predators that eat a wide range of prey, including both invertebrates and vertebrates. Many smaller species are often, in turn, preyed upon by larger animals, and thus they play an important role in many food webs. Finally, there are four extant classes of myriapods: chilopoda, the centipedes; diplopoda, the millipedes; pauropoda, the pauropods; and Symphyla, the false centipedes. These classes contain more than 15,000 described species in over 20 orders, so let's move forward and investigate this diversity next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.